When I had heart surgery, I was destroyed. I didn't think I was going to be able to keep going in life. I didn't think I was ever going to play football again. I didn't think I would be the same kid, same person, because I was only 15 at the time, and I didn't know what to make of the whole situation. And so I was scared to death. I was scared for my life.
I think it was pure luck and God that they found out that Marcus had ASD. We used to always hear stories about kids, athletes that would be in practice in a game and just randomly fall out and couldn't be resuscitated and die.
What was the biggest blessing from his heart surgery? I'd have to say, number one, that he survived.
Mentally, I was not ready. Physically, I was not ready. I had no idea what I was getting myself into. And the thing was, I felt destroyed. I felt horrible. Mentally, horrible. And if you look back on all the pictures of me in the surgery room, actually in the bed, the face was a shell of myself. I was just a shell of me. I was just someone who was present in that body, but not present in the mind, because I felt dead inside. I was going through heart surgery. It was really tough for me to comprehend or understand what it was, or the purpose of it, or the overall thing behind it, because I think everything in life has a purpose and a reasoning. And that's what hurt me the most, because I had no understanding on why. I had no understanding on what I was supposed to get out of it. I had no understanding on what I was supposed to do with it. And of course, that destroyed me also. It killed me. But I think I just took it for what it was and found a way out. I couldn't fixate on too much on why and just go through it. Because it's, at this point, you can't change it, so you might as well just go through it.
Hello, I'm Marcus Sr. with ASD. Generally, you don't know until catastrophe happens. Point is that we had enough information that told us how common his issue was, and that it needed to be fixed. And I think the doctors had reassured him about it would be better than it was before.
Marcus doesn't give up, you know, and so when something comes his way, I know he's going to pick up and try again, because I knew, like, this wasn't forever. It was only temporary, and it was only a matter of time before Marcus got back out.
My story began to get out. I did an article on me about Better Than Ever, and how I came back from heart surgery. And there was different moments throughout that year where it kind of highlighted my heart surgery, which was fine, totally great. And I finally found a space of comfortability with looking in the mirror and seeing the scar every day, like 100%. Like, and I know a lot of people say don't, no off days, no breaks. I was actually at a point where I was committed to running myself to death. Like, I was committed to actually, like, if this last sprint kills me, then so be it. And that's insane. And I think that's part of the pain that pushed me because I refused to allow anything to kill me like that. I refused to allow anything to destroy me.
One thing I admire most about Marcus is his resilience. Through it all, he has decided that whatever comes his way, he's going to take it head on.
It's 4:30 in the morning on a Monday. I had the choice. I want to sleep in for another rest day like I did Sunday. I want to get up and do my walk. Get up and get better. See, everybody got a choice. Everybody got a choice at the end of the day. You have the choice to get better or stay the same. Today, I chose to get better. This is not for everybody. Woke up the days that I only wanted to get up. Only on the days that I wanted to get up. I wouldn't get up half of the days I got up.
And we were just doing regular drills, footwork things, going in and out of the drill, in and out of the ladder, and I went back and just fell forward, snap. And what I initially thought was that I thought it was a cramp or a slight, yeah, I thought it was a cramp, a little pain. Got up, started walking on it, and it wasn't fine. I was walking on it, and I was like to the side, just bringing it along, but I felt like I was still fine. Got it checked out, and once I finally got it checked out, I went on and just went to the MRI. Me and my dad, we got it. I mean, I was in good spirits about it, but then later that day, my dad finally got a call on the results, and we met right in the middle of the stairs of our house, and he said, hey, it's a ruptured Achilles. That's when things changed. I was terrified of what was to come. I was scared of what was to come. I knew I'd had heart surgery, and it was taken from me again.
Put that mask on me.
You was out of there.
I was thinking like, nah, don't go to sleep. 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 Man, I was gone. I was ready to go lift. I was ready to get right.
The heart surgery was definitely different than Achilles because it was kind of finite. It was final. The Achilles, there was just a great unknown because just simply we know that Achilles injuries are generally a one-year injury. And it being his senior year, he had some business that he wanted to attend to on the field that would have probably been in his best interest.
Those same kind of what if scenarios did run through his mind. What if this was the last time I was, you know, able to do the things that I love in the manner that I'm normally able to do them? I think that a lot of the thoughts in his mind were of what could the outcome be.
And I think the injury to his Achilles hurt him more because it seemed like I put in all of this work after a heart surgery, a near-death experience, really. And it doesn't seem like my dreams want me to attain them.
Just relax, man. Relax. Chill out.
My leg. My leg.
Good.
You good?
Yeah. Can't feel nothing in it though.
My name is Mike Morales. My wife and I own High Performance Fitness here in Madison, Illinois. We first met Marcus in the year 2020, and as you already know, that was a rough year for a lot of people, especially for him. When we first met Marcus, he came to us with a small injury. Now, obviously that's not a small injury, and that's one of the roughest injuries for an athlete to recover from. And as you already know, he did. And it wasn't easy. Let me tell you a little bit about what happened. So when we first met, I knew this kid was somebody special. Dealing with this injury was not an easy task. I'm sure many of us know that getting over an injury is not easy, especially mentally. During Marcus's first months over here was during the time of COVID, so we had a lot of restrictions. We had to do one-on-one sessions, but that allowed us to spend a lot of quality time together. He was quiet, he was reserved, but he was always intent. He always wanted to be better. He always looked you in the eye, but he didn't reveal a lot about himself. That trust had to be earned. Because of his injury, doing the simple things were pretty difficult. Getting from the car inside the facility, from coming in here, changing his shoes, just getting himself ready, the simple things that we take for granted were so difficult for him. And I'm sure that was so frustrating for him to deal with because he's a supreme athlete. And we knew that he was just going through something. It was difficult getting the ball rolling for the first couple weeks. We knew that he was dealing with this injury. We knew that it was weighing on him, and he just had to get out of this hole where he had to believe in himself to be able to do what he wanted to do. And it wasn't easy. Building one's confidence up isn't an easy task. And we could tell that he just wasn't that confident because of what he was going through. Setting people up for success is what needed to be done. Achieving small goals over and over and over again are pretty addicting, and he wanted to take his stuff to the next level. It was not an easy task to overcome what he was going through. I can't tell you how many times I've seen tears coming down his face, frustration, because he knew that he could be better. He wanted to be better. He worked to be better. That's all he knew in life. Being mediocre at something is not in his DNA. Even with his injury, nothing would stop him. He was consistent, and he worked his ass off every single time, and always wanted more. And mind you, this guy came into us pretty chubby because he was out of shape because of his injury and just mentally out of it. Until one day, he came in, fresh cut, fresh shave, tight shirt, and that's where he earned the name Nunu. It's Nunu because he came in here a new person. New energy, new belief in himself.
Through it all, heart surgery, Achilles surgery, I had to understand that I was nothing without my family. Because the thing is, when I was at my deepest, darkest moments, throughout those surgeries, my family was there the entire time. My family were the ones who took care of me. They were the ones who watched over me and showed love and care, not because I was their son or brother, but because they saw how much my situations hurt me. They saw how much I was going through. And they just wanted to help. And so, Mom, I love you. Dad, I love you. Olivia, I love you. Danielle, I love you. Anne, I love you.